Welcome to the Smoke Learning channel. In the previous video, we displaced our flat 2D logo into a 3D extrusion and smoothed out the edges. Let's now focus on expanding the edges and getting the ability to customize the color of the extruded edge. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you are watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. Continuing in Connect Effects, I am going to select the original logo source clip. Looking at the fill, you can see that this logo was saved as an unpremultiplied source. To control the colors of the extruded edges, we need to clean this up. So we'll pre-multiply the logo over a color. Hover over the Connect Effects node bin and press B for Blend and Comp. Drag out a Blend and Comp node and drop it into the logo's fill connection. Next, connect the logo's alpha into the first blue input of Blend and Comp. So that's just pre-multiplying the logo over virtual black. But let's add a color frame to control what color the logo is composited on. Drag out a color frame node from the Connect Effects node bin. Connect the color frame node into the green background input of Blend and Comp. A problem is being flagged by the indicators in the Blend and Comp node. This always points to a resolution problem. The logo comes from a PNG file, which is HD 8-bit. Double-click on the color source node. The color frame is being generated in 16-bit float. Change the bit depth to 8-bit to match the logo. The error indications go off, and selecting the Blend and Comp node will show you the composited result. Go back to the color frame node. Click the color pot and change the color to a shade of gray. So returning back to the Blend and Comp node, we want our logo to be extruded and the edges will be this shade of gray for now. Next, we will expand the edges of the alpha so that the gray color will get considered in the 3D extrusion. Switch to the Connect Effects node bin. Press M for matte edge. Drag that into the Connect Effects schematic. Connect the alpha clip into the matte edge node. Do not touch the alpha connection going into the Blend and Comp node. This connection is specifically affecting the logo over a color. We only want to affect the alpha and displacement used in action. With that said, connect the output of the matte edge node into the alpha of Action's media input 2. Next, take another connection and connect it into the front input of Action's media input 3. Double-click on the matte edge node to see its controls. Toggle shrink on and off. You can see in the result view what shrink is doing to the matte. Now, this might not make any sense just looking at the result of the matte edge node. So let's set a context in Action to see what this will do to the extrusion and alpha. Hover over the Action node in the Connect Effects schematic. Hold the dash keyboard shortcut and click on the Action node to set it as the first context, C1. Hover over the result view and press Ctrl 1 to see the first contextual view from Action. Select the matte edge node again to activate its controls. Drag the shrink slider into negative values. When shrink is negative, it grows the alpha instead of shrinking it. Settle at a value of minus 10. Decrease the softness to 0.5. Looking at what we have in the context view, you will see a gray edge around the logo. Press F4 to switch to the result view and the matte edge result. Select the Action node and go back into Action. Choose the Node Preferences, Rendering tab, and enable shading to see the global lighting on the logo. So the lighting makes a big difference in seeing the detail of the extrusion. Change to the Action schematic and double-click on the logo's main axis. Rotate it around to see the different angles. We'll tweak the lighting later. But let's say, for instance, I want the logo's edge to be black instead of grey. Hover over the action schematic and press Ctrl-Escape to go back to the Connect Effects schematic. Select the Color Frame node. Change the color to black by clicking the color pot. Select the Action node again, and you can see the result in the viewer. So that's a flat logo extruded into a 3D model in Smoke. In the final video, we will be adding finishing touches such as lighting, 3D text, and animation to finish this off. If you would like more of these videos, then please let me know. Comments and feedback are always appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.